So, here we are. We've arrived at our 12th and final concert of the season. I'm delighted if you're watching us, whether you're from the club, Real Music Club, elsewhere in Wales, from Switzerland, from Australia, from America, wherever you're watching. People will pick this up, no doubt, on YouTube. I hope you enjoy it. We desperately hope, of course, that come October 21, we'll be live again. Music live is what we all want. Online is great, but not a patch on live. So let's hope that with all the protocols in place, we'll be able to go live in October. That's our intention. We've had several pianists this season for logistical reasons. It's very much easier to record pianists. And one feature that I feel identifies all of them is that they are what I would call serious and unshowy. I don't think we really like showy, flamboyant pianists. We've had Rose McLachlan, we've had Ellis Thomas, we've had Aisa Ejiri, Lara Melder, and tonight we have Dinara Klinton. Let me tell you a bit more about Dinara Klinton. She's already played for us once this season with flautist Naomi Giori, and she's also visited us at the club twice personally as a soloist. Two things have happened of late which have boosted her career considerably. One of them is that she's been made assistant professor at the Royal College of Music. Incidentally, the Royal College of Music is regularly at the top, the very top of world rankings of conservatoires. So that is a big leg up for her, I think. The second thing that's happened 12 days ago from when you see this concert, and that is that a new recording of all 9 Prokofiev sonatas has been issued by her. Very few young pianists ever get to record anything, let alone a 3-CD chunk of what must be perhaps the 20th century's major set of piano sonatas. Interestingly, Prokofiev was born in the Ukraine, near the Black Sea, as was Dinara, although in Kharkiv. Interestingly again, they both went and studied in Russia. I think Dinara is an ideal person to have recorded those sonatas. She's serious about them, she thinks about them. Buy the recordings and see what you think, or watch online, as no doubt will become possible eventually. However, on to tonight's concert. What we've got is another Russian, which you may or may not have heard of, Sergei Taneyev, a Prelude and Fugue. We've got some Beethoven. We've gone down under for some Percy Grainger, quite an unusual addition to our normal concert programme. We've got a very famous piece, which you might have had at one of your personal occasions, that's the Wedding March, Mendelssohn, but in this case, transcribed first by Liszt, and then subsequently, even further, by Horowitz. And a final little post-meal amuse bouche, which is a bit of a nonsensical thing to say, I know, but you will enjoy it. It's by Earl Wild. Listen right to the end for an absolute delight. But for now, the plane having gone over our heads, which you probably heard just now, I would like to welcome you to our concert and to Dinara Klinton.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening, ladies and gentlemen. These past months were not easy for any of us, but we are somehow making it through still. And I guess that's because of love. Love to what we are doing, love to each other, love to the nature and to the whole being. So the second half of my program was devoted to love. And I'm going to do a little encore now, which is also continuing the theme. It's going to be an etude by Earl Wild, which is based on the famous Gershwin song, The Man I Love.